Working with images on the web can be very challenging, but not if you're using sensible image defaults. And this is exactly what I'll show you in this video, a set of CSS rules that you should be copy-pasting into all of your projects. I will go over each line of the CSS that we will share here and show you exactly what difference it can make for your images. Let's dive in. Before we jump into the code, I want to make it perfectly clear that this technique was shared by Harry Roberts on Twitter. Link is going to be in the description, and you should absolutely follow Harry on Twitter. You should follow his blog. He writes about performance, and his articles are pure gold, so you should absolutely follow him wherever you can find him. I will go over each line of this technique and show you exactly what every CSS rule set here does. I will jump into CodePen. We have a simple component here, and everything you need to know about this demo is that we have this image here in the HTML, and we're setting width and height attributes, source attribute, and then we have the style attribute with the background image set, which is a low quality image placeholder for this particular image you're seeing on the page right now. And lastly, we have an alt attribute that describes exactly what this image is about. Let's jump into CSS now, and let's start applying those sensible defaults. The first major problem that we have with this image that you can very clearly see yourself is that this image is a little bit too wide and it's going beyond the bounds of this container. And that is exactly why we will enable first two rules. If we set max width of this image to 100%, it will no longer go outside of the bounds. So you always want to set this. Whenever you find yourself that container or window size is smaller than the image will resize exactly as it should. But the problem with this now is that this image is distorted because it no longer maintains its aspect ratio. And therefore, we will enable the second rule, height auto, which will maintain its exact aspect ratio along with the max width 100%. So if you want to make sure that your image is not distorted and it doesn't go outside of the bounds of its container, then add max width 100% and height auto properties to your CSS as image defaults. The next problem that we have here might not be so obvious, but in some cases it can be very, very annoying. And you're gonna see it very clearly if I select my image and text with the mouse. As you can see, there is empty space underneath my image, and this is almost never what I want. The reason for this empty space is that image is an inline element and it's affected by line height and vertical align. By default, vertical align is set to baseline, which means that this image will be a little bit higher than the bottom of the line, and therefore we have this empty space. This is exactly what this next CSS rule fixes. If you set vertical align to middle, you will never have empty space underneath your images, and you'll be able to align them properly with the rest of the content without any problems. The next rule we have here, font style italic, is related to alt attribute. Every image has to have an alt attribute. This is important for screen readers and accessibility, but also if for some reason your image doesn't load properly, alt attribute will be shown on the page. And to demonstrate this, I will jump into my HTML, and here I will break the links to both of my sources, my original source and my low quality image source. And when I do this, alt text that I've defined here, a printed sheet of CSS theme stickers on a desk, is visible in my component. And the problem we have right now is that this text is not distinguishable from the rest of the text in my content. Or rather, this doesn't seem like it belongs to image, it seems like it belongs to the content itself, to this block of text right here. And therefore, we're gonna set font style to italic, which will make my alt text distinguishable from the rest of the content. This is exactly what I want. The next two rules we have here are related to low quality image placeholder technique. This is a technique where you show low quality image that loads really fast before an actual image is downloaded and shown. That way, users will see something relevant before an actual image loads. And I'm gonna jump into my HTML here, and I'm gonna enable my image placeholder. To make this problem even more apparent, I will add display inline block to my CSS to make this image keep its aspect ratio, display inline block. And now you see that my placeholder image is being repeated all over the place. That is not what I want, so we will enable background repeat no repeat property. And now, of course, we also need to enable background size cover because we want this background to cover entirety of our available space. And now we have this low quality image placeholder, and once the actual image is loaded, which will be this one, this image will go away and it will be replaced exactly by the image that we want. So those two rules, background repeat and background size, are here to make sure that you don't have to do anything when you're working with low quality image placeholders. Before I show you what the next line does, make sure to hit that subscribe button. It is really important for this technique to work. I'm kidding, of course, but it would mean a lot if you would subscribe to this channel. Thanks so much if you do. The last rule we have here, shape margin, is related to shape outside property. The shape outside property allows you to define an element around which inline content, such as text, will wrap. To show you this, I've prepared another demo, and I will just paste my code right here. So this image will be floated with fixed width and height, and the wrapping text around the shape is done with the shape outside property, while the clip pad is cutting away visually part of that particular element, in this case, this image. The problem with this now is that this text seems very cluttered because there's no space, there's no padding between my element and my actual text. And that's why we have shape margin here in the defaults. I will enable it and you'll see immediately that a little bit of spacing is added between my element, between the margin of my element and the actual content or this text in this button. And this is exactly what I want by default. Again, this technique was shared by Harry Roberts. All credit goes to him, and make sure to follow him on Twitter and wherever you can find them, especially follow his blog. He writes fantastic articles and you should be reading those. I'm definitely going to be using this for my own images. I recommend you do the same. Copy and paste this into your CSS and you'll be certain that your images will be as good as possible by default. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different image placeholder, or rather, in the next video.